You're watching the Beer Channel.
May be one of the most unique stops on your rounds through the district. Boasting a phenomenal 5-bar environments, Jack Rose Dining Saloon is sure to make an impression. Not only will you find, quite possibly, the largest public bourbon and scotch collection in the Western Hemisphere, with over 1,000 bottle selections, there is a phenomenal tap rotation and beer bottle list as well. Bells, Duval, Harpoon, New Holland, Evolution, Omegon, and Goose Island are some of the more regularly available selections. There are also drafts that are exclusive to Jack Rose from Schloss and others. The food menus are equally abundant. Seared steak, steamed mussels, stuffed quail, roasted chicken, and several smaller bite dishes. The layout is exquisitely detailed. Light and dark woods under a pressed tin ceiling join the long marble bar top to create a very open dining area. Rolling ladders allow the bartenders to reach spirits well above eye level. Leather booths with mahogany tables run down the left wall, each adorned with soft light fixtures to add an extra element of comfort while you take it all in. Downstairs, you'll find a very exclusive, high-end bottle-only scotch cellar. Essentially, it is a private bar that can be booked or used for those that wish to experience a quieter time. Moving to the top of the building, you'll find 3 additional bar environments. There is a very nicely sized, heated open-air terrace with a retractable roof at the top of the stairs. A very long bar extends across the tiled floor against the far wall. High bar chairs with slotted wooden backs create a second dining area within this space. This also doubles as a space to enjoy one of many cigar selections. There are plenty of draft, bottle, and canned craft beers available. To the left, you'll find a tiki bar that is open from Thursday to Sunday. There is a sliding glass door to separate it from the main area, a tiled floor, a smaller bar with 6 to 8 high-back chairs, and large balcony-sized windows. There are cans of Kona Longboard and Pale Ale available. The other end of the open-air terrace reveals a balcony bar. This also has a sliding glass door with the addition of a fireplace. There is a smaller bar with high back chairs, a separate sliding door exposing a balcony, a wooden floor, and a rotation of 5 craft beers.
Nahem Simon here, inviting you to Jack Rose Dining Saloon and Bourbon Adams Morgan during the CBC. We're going to have tons of great events, tons of great beers, and on top of that, more whiskey than we know what to do with. Cocktails, food, the whole 9, the whole 10. And we're just really looking forward to having everybody that's going to be in town at least just stop by, check us out. We're going to have our basement bar open. That's been something that a lot of people have been looking forward to. And then we've got a little something for everybody. And really just looking forward to having one or many of beers with everybody that stops by.
DCBeer.com describes the Black Squirrel as conceived as a place that combines good beer with good food and an atmosphere that is grown up yet unpretentious. This 3-level townhome establishment provides exactly that with 3 different environments in which to enjoy your visit. The food menu is simple and approachable. Beef and vegetarian burgers, salads, sandwiches, soups, and a great appetizer menu. The street-level bar offers 30 rotating taps of amazing beer, a long bar and space with round tops on the right wall, and bar stools if you'd rather be right up front. There are old concert posters and plenty of beer-related paraphernalia on the walls. The main floor bar is a smaller space with a great spot right in front of a huge street front window, a smaller wooden bar with about 20 taps, and a few tables along the left wall. The second floor is a fun late evening and weekend space they use to promote their Belgian ale selections. This space is also available for private functions. Labels throughout include Blue Mountain, Aviator, Elysian, Port City, Anderson Valley, Speakeasy, Ninkasi, Heavy Seas, Green Flash, and more. It doesn't stop there. The Black Squirrel also offers 5 different labels of absinthe. Leopold Brothers, St. George, Lucid, Kubler, and Pernod Phil are all prepared to entice the divine and awaken the soul. This quaint location in Adams Morgan is full of surprises. Not only should you expect to find a tempting small batch bourbon list, you'll also find a gem of a restaurant with a great craft beer list. The outside looks much like the rest of the district, a multiple level townhome converted into a bar or other business. This 2-story cream-colored building opens to a wonderful back patio space that is a popular spot for happy hour and brunch. There is a second level bar area and comfortable loft space to hang with friends. The food menus are what could be considered as comfortable. Salads. Soups. Burgers. Sandwiches. Chicken and biscuits. Fish. And a great starter menu of terrific items to share. They have a very diverse craft beer rotation with labels such as Avery, 3 Stars, Stone, Stillwater, DC Brow, Omegang, and a wide variety of others. If there were 2 words to describe this unique establishment, they might be abundant refreshment. Smoke and Barrel is a wonderland of exactly what's posted on the door. Beer, barbecue, bourbon. They have an interesting take on the barbecue. Slow cooked over hickory and spent bourbon barrels. The restaurant itself is situated in a 3-level townhome, making it fit right in with the rest of Adams Morgan. The interior is exposed brick walls with weathered old boards of mushroom wood, reclaimed from Amish barns in Pennsylvania. The bar stools are all spent barrels as well. There are over 100 bottle selections of whiskey, consisting of mostly high-end and small-batch bourbons from Kentucky. A main attraction to Smoke and Barrel, aside from all of that, is the Boilermaker cocktail list. Pairing beer with a shot of whiskey is an old tradition, but a lot of thought has been put into the flavor profiles of these cocktails. In the Governor Howe, for example, a shot of Woodford Reserve is poured into a pint glass and then topped with Gubna IPA from Oscar Blues. The Scotchy Scotch Scotch is a blend of Glenfiddich and Oscar Blues Old Chub. Smoke and Barrel truly is a celebration of flavors. They offer a regular rotation of 24 taps and 25 cans to complement. Some are intentionally selected to pair with barbecue, including the dark, rich Urgestick Altbier from Dusseldorf, Germany, and the Sierra Nevada Dogfish Head collaboration, Life and Limb. Other selections include great craft beers from Firestone Walker, Ballast Point, Oxbow, Mother Earth, Mad Fox, 21st Amendment, DC Brow, Avery, and 6 Point. Thanks for watching. In the 5th and final episode of the CBC and DC series, we visit Port City Brewing Company in Alexandria, Virginia. Then we head to Rustico in Ballston, Lion Hall, and we wrap things up at Mad Fox Brewing in Falls Church, Virginia, where we speak with head brewer, Bill Madden.